Hi, my name is Mark. Greetings to all my fellow truth seekers and brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. How many explanations have you heard for the last trump? Some Christians argue that the last trump is the seventh trumpet in the book of Revelation, while other Christians argue that the seventh trumpet in Revelation cannot be the trumpet that is sounded at the time of the rapture of the church, because the trumpets in Revelation are the trumpets of judgment and the wrath of God. And the Word of God clearly states that the church is not appointed to the wrath of God. Now both sides present reasonably good arguments. So which side is the truth? One argument I have heard from both sides is, well, that is just your interpretation. So here is my interpretation, which is based upon very plain and simple words. Let's begin this study in God's Word by reading two very familiar passages of Scripture. The first one is found in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 13 through 18. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that you sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent or go before them which are asleep, those who have died in Jesus Christ. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God. And the dead in Christ shall rise first, then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up, or raptured, together with them in the clouds, to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore comfort one another with these words. In this passage of Scripture we just read, which pertains to the catching up, or the rapture of the church, I want you to notice that there will be a sounding of a trumpet, and that the rapture occurs or takes place at the time of the sounding of this trump or trumpet of God. Now let's read 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 51 and 52. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. Now in both of these passages of Scripture, we see the dead in Christ being raised or resurrected from the dead, and changed or given immortality. And we also see that at the time of this event, which has come to be called the rapture of the church, we see the trump or trumpet of God being sounded or blown. Now I want you to notice two very important clues found in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 51 and 52, as to when the catching up or rapture of the church will take place. First, I want to draw your attention to the phrase at, or at the time or moment of, the last trump. Now to those who want to argue, well, that is just your interpretation, I say, how can these very plain and simple words be interpreted any other way? The Word of God clearly states that this event will occur at the last trump. And quite honestly, I do not know any other definition for the word last, other than that there will be none that follow or come after. In other words, the trump or trumpet that shall sound at the time of the rapture will be the last trumpet to sound. Therefore, there will be no other trumpets to sound after this trump or trumpet shall sound. So consequently, when we read in Matthew chapter 24, verses 29 through 31, where we find a sounding of a trumpet, we must therefore honestly and openly consider the possibility of this trumpet being the last trumpet that shall sound, because it most certainly will be a trumpet that shall sound after any so-called pre-tribulation trumpet. So let's read Matthew chapter 24, verses 29 through 31 to see when this trumpet shall sound. Immediately after the tribulation of those days, speaking of the time of great tribulation, shall the sun be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light, and the stars shall fall from heaven, and the powers of heaven shall be shaken. And then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn. And they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And he, Jesus, shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet. And they shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. Now those that teach a pre-tribulation rapture argue that the elect are the chosen people of God, Israel, or the Jews, and not the church. But the plain and simple meaning of the word elect is simply the chosen. So therefore, does not the word of God tell us that the church has been chosen to be the bride of Christ? Please keep in mind the clear, plain, and simple definition of the word last. For you see, my dear brothers and sisters in the Lord, this trumpet in Matthew 24, verse 31, is sounded immediately after the time of great tribulation. So consequently, it is impossible for there to be any pre-tribulation rapture, because there is yet another trumpet to sound after the great tribulation. Plain and simple. Last means last, therefore there will be no other trumpets to sound after the last trumpet. So very simply, the rapture takes place at the time of the last trumpet, which is sounded, immediately after the tribulation of those days. Now let's take a look at the second clue found in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 51. Please consider closely the phrase, "Behold, I show you a mystery." We know that the mystery that has been shown to us, the church, the prophets and servants of God, is the rapture of the church, when the dead in Christ are resurrected, and we all are changed together in a moment and a twinkling of an eye. We also know that this event will take place, be accomplished, or completed at the time when the last trumpet is sounded. Furthermore, we know that there are seven trumpets to be sounded in the book of Revelation, and that the seventh trumpet is, of course, the last trumpet in the sequence of these seven trumpets. Please consider closely Revelation chapter 10, verse 7. "But in the days of the voice of the seventh, our last angel, when he shall begin to sound, the mystery of God should be finished or accomplished, as he has declared to his servants the prophets." Please keep in mind the words of Paul, "Behold, I show or declare unto you a mystery." Both of these verses refer to a mystery that is accomplished or finished at the time when the last trumpet is sounded. And remember, the trumpet is sounded immediately after the time of great tribulation, at which time the elect of God are gathered together in the clouds, which is exactly where 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16 tells us that we, the church, are caught up together to meet Jesus in the clouds. Thanks for watching. Please view part 2 of "The Trumpet of God Shall Sound." To find any of my videos, please click on my channel name, A Matter of Truth, or where it says videos above. And for more in-depth studies on this or other subjects, please visit my website at amatteroftruth.com.